I'm here in the StudyCo Oman office, and I wanted to take this opportunity to answer some common FAQs from students and parents. Number one, so at StudyCo, we do the entire application and visa process for you free of charge. So that means we have counselors that help students decide exactly what they want to study, which university is best for that area of study, and the right destination country to suit all your needs. We then gather your documents and the rest is done by us. Number two. So StudyCo assists in finding the right accommodation options, and we generally recommend that the student stays on campus for the first year of their degree. Health cover, we have a great provider in Allianz, and the processes are done entirely through us. In terms of the on-the-ground support, StudyCo's headquarters are located in Australia with countless onshore services available to students at all times. Students or parents can get in touch with any StudyCo staff across our offices in over 20 countries, and we will help you out. We can even take care of your travel needs. So we provide a truly comprehensive service. And don't forget, it's free. Question number three. So we know that permanent residency and migration is always on everyone's minds, especially when it comes to studying in Australia. At StudyCo, we have great migration agents that can personally help guide you through the entire process, including any questions you have. We are all about making things just that much easier for students, parents, and teachers. And the final question, why Australia? So at StudyCo, we send students to study across the entire world. There isn't a single country we haven't tapped into yet. So you can come to us with any destination you have in mind. We do specialize in Australia, and as you all know, Australian institutions are ranked amongst the top in the world, and so is our standard of living. These universities also offer great part scholarships, grants, and are ranked very highly for graduate employability. So I think that definitely solves a lot of the concerns that all the parents out there would have. If you have any other questions, our office in Koorum is open for business, and you can come meet us and any of our StudyCo staff at any time. Hope to see you there.
I am Vishwanath Praveen, Assistant Head Boy of Indian School Muscat. It's an honor to have our prominent keynote speaker, popular for his unique English words, former Under Secretary General of the United Nations, recipient of Pravasi Bharatiya Samman, India's highest honor for overseas Indians, and renowned author, our chief guest, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, Honorable Member of Parliament. We welcome and thank you, sir, for gracing this valedictory function of Avenir 2020.
I'm Anjali Amnitan, head girl, Indian School Muscat. I find immense pleasure to welcome our honorable chief guest and keynote speaker, author, former international civil servant and UN peacekeeper, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, Honourable Member of Parliament, to the valedictory function, Avenir 2020.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are delighted to have you all with us today for Avenir 2020, Be Future Ready, a mission to enkindle the minds of students in diversified fields and motivate them to choose the course of their interest and caliber. I'm Palkin Jain of Class 11F from Indian School Muscat, and it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all this beautiful afternoon. Intelligent, bright minds, today we are privileged to have with us an eminent personality from Waikato University, New Zealand, who will enlighten us about their campus and the courses available with them and career prospects. Let's watch a video of Waikato University.
This is the University of Waikato, where every day people are making a positive change. Where research helps tackle global challenges and elite athletes can compete at the top of their game. A place where people are given the tools to protect their whenua for future generations. Where talent is nurtured and excellence is celebrated. It's a place where industry, innovation, and education converge, and where moments are shared with loved ones. It's a place where teaching and learning has no borders, and people of all races and cultures work together as one. Our people, our future. Positive change starts here.
Over to you, sir or ma, for your presentation.
Okay, well, good morning, everybody, or good afternoon, I should say, over in Oman. My name is Richard Witts, and I am Regional Manager for Africa, Middle East, and Europe at the University of Waikato in New Zealand. And today I'm going to give you a bit of an introduction to studying in New Zealand and to the University of Waikato. New Zealand isn't probably a destination that you have spent a lot of time thinking about in terms of your international future of study. And so hopefully today I can give you a few reasons why you might want to consider New Zealand as a study destination, and then tell you a bit about where I work, which is the University of Waikato, one of 8 universities in New Zealand. And then, of course, at the end of the presentation, there should be some time for questions and discussion, and I'm happy to answer any questions that you might have. So I'm going to share my screen now, and we can start the presentation from there. Okay, Firstly, I should say that I've visited the Middle East a number of times, and I've also visited Oman a few times, and I'm always very impressed by the expat community in Oman. I know that there are a lot of students at very good schools that have excellent grades and that do really well in their university studies overseas. The University of Waikato is a very multicultural university. We have a number of international students from all around the world, and we welcome students from the Middle East, students from India, students from many different parts of the world every year. So it really is a great place for you to study. Now, first of all, here, if you don't know very much about New Zealand, you may not know exactly where it is in the world. So we'll start with the basics, and you can see the map, the world map on the left, and a map of New Zealand on the right of this slide. So New Zealand is close to Australia. It's about a 3-hour flight from Sydney. It's actually, well, if you fly from the Middle East, you can fly directly from either Dubai or Qatar from Doha. It's quite a long flight. It's about 17 or 18 hours to get to New Zealand, but it is a direct flight, so it's not too difficult to manage. New Zealand itself is split into two islands. You have the North Island and the South Island, as you can see on the right-hand side. The capital city of New Zealand is Wellington, but the biggest city in New Zealand is Auckland. So the population of New Zealand as a whole is about 5 million people. That's quite a lot smaller than maybe what you're used to, and means that there's a lot more space, a lot more green, really beautiful areas to explore. And the way of life, the lifestyle, is a lot more laid back than other countries, such as Australia or the UK, US, Canada, and so on. As I say, the biggest city is Auckland, and Auckland has a population of about 1.5 million people. There are actually 8 universities spread across New Zealand. So there are 2 universities in Auckland, and then the rest are spread throughout the North and the South Island. The University of Waikato has 2 campuses. The first one is in Hamilton, so that is about an hour and a half south of Auckland. And then the second campus is in Tauranga, which is just about 2 hours from Auckland. So you can see the 2 red dots on the map there. Now, as I say, I always tell students when they are thinking about their study destination that if they choose New Zealand, they shouldn't expect a big 24-hour party lifestyle with huge cities and lots of people, lots of crowds and hustle and bustle. New Zealand is more laid back. So if you prefer a more laid back way of life, if the quality of living is important to you, if you want to escape the huge numbers of international students that you find in the big cities such as Sydney and Melbourne, and if you like nature and the outdoors, then definitely New Zealand would be a study destination that you might want to consider. So just to give you a bit more information about where we are, as I say, our main campus is in Hamilton. So this is Hamilton City. As I say, it's about an hour and a half south of Auckland. The population of Hamilton is about 165,000 people. You can see this is the main city centre in the middle of the picture here. And running through the city, you can see the Waikato River. So the University of Waikato is named after the Waikato River. And in fact, the whole region is called the Waikato region. So the university itself is located about 15 minutes away from the city centre by bus. So you can take a bus from the centre across that bridge you can see over to the outskirts of the city, and you'll come to our beautiful Hamilton campus. Now, before I go any further and talk to you about the University of Waikato itself, I want to introduce you to New Zealand and show you some of the reasons you might want to choose New Zealand as a study destination. So I've got some beautiful photos here that illustrate how New Zealand looks and the beautiful places that you can explore if you were to come and study with us. So the first one here, this is Bridal Veil Falls. This is a beautiful waterfall located about 30 minutes from Hamilton. And this is a typical beauty spot, a natural spot of scenic beauty in New Zealand. You'll find hundreds of these places all across the country. So, you know, you could go. You could take a picnic lunch. You could start your walk at the top of the waterfall, walk down to the bottom, enjoy the peaceful scenery, the birds, all of nature all around you. It's very, very different to the landscape of Oman and the Middle East, and of course of India as well. So, as I say, there are so many places that you can visit like this in New Zealand, and this is just one example. Now, if you have watched Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit movie trilogies, then you may have come across Hobbiton, and you may know that the movies were actually filmed in New Zealand. So this is the Hobbiton movie set, and this is about an hour from Hamilton. It's very close to Tauranga, to our secondary campus. And you can go for a Lord of the Rings experience. You can walk around, you can see the Hobbit holes. You can take a drink in the inn and get a real experience of Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit. So a lot of people who visit New Zealand do go and visit Hobbiton, and it's a really interesting place to visit and a really beautiful place, as you can see here. You're never far away from the beach if you live in New Zealand, and Raglan Beach is about half an hour away from our main campus in Hamilton. Again, if you're the adventurous type and you like surfing, then you may have heard of Raglan. It's it has one of the most famous left-hand surf breaks worldwide. So lots of surfers, professional surfers, flock to Raglan to enjoy the great surfing conditions. But it's just half an hour from Hamilton, and again, a great place to spend time, to spend your day. And if you study in our secondary campus of Tauranga, then that's actually on the coast and right on the beach, so really, really close to the sea. Then this is Rotorua. This is, again, very close to Tauranga, about an hour from Hamilton. And this is where you will find hot springs. So this is geothermal activity, hot water coming out of the ground. And you can go and bathe in the hot springs, very well known for the restorative qualities. And again, a great place to go and visit and explore. Again, if you're into the more sort of adventurous side of life, then you might want to try skiing or snowboarding. And in the New Zealand winter, so that's in June and July, August time, then you can go and visit the ski fields. These are in the centre of the North Island, and you can go and try out the, again, excellent skiing conditions. You can see the mountain scenery here, and a great place to go and visit and explore. And then finally, no visit to New Zealand is complete without going down to the South Island. The South Island is one of the most spectacular places in the world to visit, as illustrated by this image here. And, you know, if you like outdoors and you like nature, then you really will enjoy exploring the South Island, seeing the beautiful mountain scenery, the crystal.
So, sorry to interrupt, but there is a fluctuation in your voice.
Okay. If you're still struggling to hear me, then I will try to reconnect my internet. Let me know. Are you still having problems hearing me?
Not right now.
Okay. If you're having any further problems, then I'll try to reconnect my internet. But it should be okay. Okay, so I'll go back to the presentation. So the South Island is really a spectacular place to visit, and it really is a wonderful place to see if you do visit New Zealand. So next I want to talk to you about why you might want to choose New Zealand as a study destination. You've seen the beautiful places that you can visit in New Zealand, but New Zealand has far more to offer to students than just that. So first of all, safety is one of the really big concerns for international students these days. And parents particularly want their sons and daughters to study in a country that is safe and secure, away from the sort of the crime and the more sort of unstable places that we see in the world today. So New Zealand is actually the second most peaceful country in the world, according to the 2020 Global Peace Index. So that means that the crime rate is very low, and it means that really you have very little worry about studying in New Zealand and studying with us in terms of safety and security. All of the campuses in New Zealand have 24-hour security, and really we have very, very few problems with safety of our students. The second thing is quality. So obviously parents and students want to study in a quality at a quality study destination. So all New Zealand universities are actually ranked within the top 500 worldwide in the QS 2021 world rankings. As I say, there are 8 universities spread across New Zealand. So wherever you study in New Zealand, you're guaranteed a quality education and a really strong...
Sir, there is still a bit fluctuation in your voice.
Okay. I can try to reconnect to a different internet source. Just hold on a second.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so can you hear me now? Is everything okay?
Yes,
you can hear me? Okay, good.
Yes.
Okay, right, I'll continue. Let me know if there are any further problems, but hopefully that should solve it. So as I was saying, all of the New Zealand universities are ranked within the top 500 in the world in the QS 2021 rankings. So it's a really great quality destination, study destination. The third aspect that you may want to consider is work opportunities. So most international students are eligible for a 3-year post-study work visa after graduation. So that means you can work in New Zealand after graduating from university for 3 years in nearly any job across the country. So if you complete a bachelor's degree with us, then you will be able to, you will be eligible for that 3-year post-study work visa. And I'll talk about that more a bit later. And then finally, as I've said, the lifestyle in New Zealand really is high quality, very easygoing, stunning natural beauty. And as I say, it suits students who maybe want a bit of a slower pace of life, a bit more laid back compared to other destinations with large cities and large numbers of international students. So now I've introduced New Zealand to you, I'm going to introduce the University of Waikato. So I'll start with our rankings. Our ranking in the 2021 QS World Rankings is 375, so we're in that top 500, which is absolutely key. But we also have a Triple Crown accredited management school. Now, when I say Triple Crown accreditation, I'm talking about the 3 most important business bodies worldwide that accredit university and college business schools. And they are AACSB, Equus, and AMBA. And you can look up Triple Crown accreditation later on if you like. There's lots of information online about it. Only 100 or so management schools of universities worldwide hold Triple Crown accreditation. So it really is a prestigious accolade to hold. And the University of Waikato Management School holds Triple Crown accreditation. So that puts us well within the top 1% of management schools worldwide. So if you were to study with us and then for your CV in the future, say that you studied at a Triple Crown accredited management school, it should stand you in very good stead when you're looking to apply for a job. I've talked a bit about our location already. Hamilton is the 4th largest city in New Zealand. So I've said Auckland is the biggest, then you have Wellington and Christchurch down in the South Island. And Hamilton is the 4th largest city in New Zealand of a population of around 165,000 people, close to Auckland. And then our secondary campus, which was just built last year, is in Tauranga. And Tauranga is New Zealand's fastest growing city, lots of opportunities there, particularly for students after graduation, and a really great location to be based on the coast, beautiful sandy beaches, excellent shopping, dining opportunities, so a really good quality of life, standard of living. And the third issue you may want to consider, and I'm sure everyone is thinking about when they're thinking of studying overseas, is the cost. And studying in New Zealand is actually quite a bit cheaper than in many other countries worldwide. If you compare the tuition fees and the living costs to other study destinations such as Australia, the US, the UK, and so on, then you'll find that study in New Zealand is generally cheaper. And living costs in a smaller city, such as Hamilton or Tauranga, are cheaper than in cities such as Auckland, Sydney, and Melbourne. And I think particularly for the rent. So when you're renting an apartment or renting a house with friends or living in the university accommodation, you'll find that the living costs in Hamilton are significantly cheaper. So I showed you a picture earlier of Hamilton, and this is a photo of our Hamilton campus. So as I say, it's about 15 minutes outside of the main city, and it's spread across a beautiful area. You can see all of the green spaces, the lakes, a really excellent place to be based for your studies. So as I say, this is our main campus in the city of Hamilton. It's actually the largest campus by area in New Zealand out of all eight universities. So you'll have a really high quality experience if you do study on the Hamilton campus. I've also talked a bit about our secondary campus, which is located in the city of Tauranga. Now, Tauranga is a city of about 130,000 people. It's actually the fifth largest city in New Zealand. And we have a new purpose-built campus, which was opened at the beginning of last year. Now, this is a much smaller campus. It's self-contained in one large building. And again, it's suitable for students maybe who want a bit more of a more relaxed and laid-back lifestyle away from large numbers of other students and large cities and crowds and so on. The standard of the facilities is absolutely first class, as you can imagine. Everything was completed last year, so everything is state of the art. So the programs combine high quality teaching with the excellent world class facilities and real cutting edge research that the University of Waikato was famous for. And as I've said, Tauranga is the fastest growing city in New Zealand and really is attracting a lot of investment from businesses and a lot of migration from different parts of New Zealand to the city, which means there are excellent opportunities after graduation. And we offer a range of programs at undergraduate and postgraduate level at the Tauranga campus. If you do choose Tauranga as your study destination, then you'll be eligible for a bursary. Now, all of our international students at the moment who start their studies face-to-face in Tauranga are eligible for a bursary, and it can be up to 10,000 New Zealand dollars. This is because the campus is new and we're looking to attract more students to study in Tauranga rather than Hamilton. Just an idea of what the facilities look like. This is one of our brand new lecture theatres within the Tauranga campus. And so you can get an idea, really, the excellent quality of facilities we have. Now, something very important that apart from location and cost that I've talked about so far to international students is employability. Now, the reason that you want to study at university, I assume, is because you want to go into the employment of your choice after graduation. You want to get a good job. And we put a lot of focus on employability at the University of Waikato. So we want to ensure that our students are as employable as possible when they graduate. So most of our bachelor's degrees include a compulsory one semester internship. And that's normally in the final year of study, in the third year, and it's normally for one day per week for one semester. So that's guaranteed for most of our programs, and we will find an internship for you. And then, of course, something to add to your CV in the future. And then further on, if you're looking at postgraduate degrees, a number of our postgraduate programs also include internships. 85% of our students are employed within 12 months of completing their studies. The New Zealand economy, despite COVID-19, is strong, and employment is expected to steadily increase over the next few years. So there are opportunities when it comes to employment in New Zealand. And the New Zealand government publishes something called the long-term skill shortage list. So this changes from time to time, but gives you an idea of where skills are lacking in New Zealand and where they're needed. So at the moment, you have construction, engineering, purchasing and supply, health and social services, ICT, that's computing, and science on the long-term skill shortage list. So if you are looking to secure a job after graduation, then you may want to consider studying on one of those programs if you're looking to stay in New Zealand, that is. Now, as I've mentioned, there's a post-study work pathway that makes it easier for you to stay in New Zealand long term. So if you studied a bachelor's degree with us, then you would be eligible for that 3-year post-study work visa. You can stay in New Zealand for 3 years after your studies, work in any job. And then if you're looking to maybe stay for longer, then you would need to apply for a residency visa. And New Zealand has a points-based system that is quite similar to Australia and other countries when it comes to that. The most important aspect of that is having a job offer. You'll get a lot more points and you'll be a lot more likely to be eligible to stay long-term if you have a job offer in New Zealand. Now, I've mentioned the internships and placements that we offer. Just to give you an idea of the types of internships and placements, I've listed a few on this slide. For example, if you study the Bachelor of Business, then you'll have that 1 day per week for one semester in the third year that's guaranteed for all students. If you study the Bachelor of Engineering, you'll have 800 hours of work experience that's normally paid in years 2 and 3 of your studies. If you study an arts or humanities program, we may be able to find a placement for you with a community group or a business around Hamilton or in Tauranga. And so there are lots of different opportunities for students who are looking for internships and who maybe for them an internship is a really important part of their decision in terms of their studies. And just to finish off on employability, a very useful website to look at is Occupation Outlook. So Occupation Outlook is a New Zealand government website, and it allows you to look at different jobs and the employment prospects in New Zealand. So there's an app, and I've taken a screenshot from the app on the left of this slide. And also you can see the website there. So do go and have a look at Occupation Outlook and maybe type in your degree choice and see what job opportunities there are after that degree. You can see an example here, a couple of examples actually, engineering professionals, software developers. So there are three different barometers. The first is the income, how much money you'll earn. The second is the tuition fees, and the third is the job prospects. And these two professions actually have very strong job prospects. So if your main concern after graduation is getting a job in New Zealand, then you may want to consider studying something along the lines of engineering or software. And then, of course, you can go and drill down and see a lot more information about those professions. And I've put this screenshot of engineering professionals at the bottom of this slide. And you can look at the job prospects, the tuition fees, the universities that offer those programs, and so on. Now, presentation at the moment would be complete without talking about COVID-19. Of course, this is a worldwide pandemic. The whole world has been turned upside down because of COVID-19 this year. And obviously, study overseas has changed, or the opportunities to study overseas have changed quite a bit. Unfortunately, in the same way that Australia's borders are closed, New Zealand's borders are also closed to international students currently. At the moment, visas are not being processed for new international students, and that will be the case until at least February 2021. We're not sure when things will change. We're very hopeful that by the middle of next year, things will start to get back to normal. But at the moment, we don't know. What's important to say, though, is that New Zealand has actually eradicated COVID-19 almost completely. There are very, very few cases in the community popping up here and there, but normal life in New Zealand is just going on day to day. You know, people can attend rugby matches of 30,000 people. They can live their lives day to day, go to the shop, go to the restaurant, and do whatever they want to do. There are no real restrictions in New Zealand at the moment. But that's because the borders are closed and COVID-19 has not been let into New Zealand for a long time now. So our intakes will be online this month and also in March 2021. So if you did want to come and study with us from March of next year, you would need to start your studies online, and then you can progress to face-to-face study when the borders open. If you chose to come and study with us in March, as I say, you would start your studies online and you'd get a 20% fee reduction for your online study. And then when you come to New Zealand, you'll get a $2,000 New Zealand travel grant to help you with your travel expenses. At the moment, we're accepting provisional and calculated grades. We're accepting online English tests, such as Duolingo, IELTS indicator, and so on. And then for online students, we have a really good system, an online system, so students can watch lectures at any time. They're all recorded. Seminars and workshops are held to suit different time zones, and there's full online support from our academics and administrative staff. As I say, we're hopeful in July 2021 that things will start to get back to normal and that our July intake will be face to face, but things can change very quickly, so we need to wait and see. Now, I'm going to tell you just a bit about a few programmes that we offer. So I'm focusing on our bachelor's degrees here, obviously, but you can see the faculties and schools of study that we have at the University of Waikato. So they're all listed here. I'm not going to go through them, but you can get an idea of what we offer. And we offer most programmes. The only programmes we don't offer are medicine and dentistry and things like architecture and fine art. But most other programmes we do offer. And I've picked out a few popular programmes for international students just to give you a bit of an overview. So we'll start off with the Bachelor of Business. This is a 3-year bachelor's degree. It has 3 intakes per year, and that's in March, July and November. As I say, our next intakes are going to be online, hopefully with progression to face-to-face study. And then hopefully in July, we'll start to look at face-to-face study again when students are able to come back to New Zealand. The cost of the programme is about $30,000 New Zealand per year. That's about $20,000 US per year in tuition fees. And I've mentioned that our Triple Crown accredited management school is one of the top 1% worldwide. So you'd really be studying at one of the top study destinations for business and management. I've talked about our one semester workplace internship, but what I haven't talked about is the majors that we offer. So you can see at the bottom of the page, there's a table showing the different majors that we have in the Bachelor of Business. We have 9 different majors. You can choose between one of those 9. Some students also choose to do a double major, so they may combine 2 subjects at the same time. If you choose the accounting major, then you would be eligible for fast track to qualified chartered accountant status. And that's because our programme and the business school generally is accredited by ACCA. So normally, if you wanted to gain ACCA accreditation, you would need to take 14 exams. But if you study the Bachelor of Business majoring in accounting, you would have 9 exemptions from the 14 exams. So it means after graduation, you would only need to take 5 more exams, get some work experience that you need to be accredited, and then gain that accreditation. So it's a really good pathway to ACCA Chartered Accountancy accreditation, studying our Bachelor of Business in accounting. We also offer the Bachelor of Management Studies, and that's a 4-year degree with honours, but students can start with this 3-year degree and then transfer to the 4th year, the 4 years with honours, if they choose to at the end of their studies. Now, entry requirements, that entry requirement is for a slightly different country, but for students who are studying through the Indian system, and I've got more information about this a bit later, students studying through the Indian system would need 75% from their ISC, and then I believe 65% from their English studies in order to then get an IELTS waiver. Now, the next programme here is the Bachelor of Engineering with honours, and this is a 4-year degree. So this programme is accredited by Engineering New Zealand, and that means that it's recognised in 19 countries across the world as part of the Washington Accord. So it means that when you graduate with your Bachelor of Engineering, you can work across the world as an accredited, recognised engineer. So that's countries such as the UK, US, Canada, the UAE, India, Australia, and so on and so on. So you can really do anything you want with your bachelor's degree in engineering. It has intakes in February of July and July of each year, and the cost is just under 37,000 New Zealand dollars per year. So that's closer to around 24,000 US dollars or so per year. As I've mentioned, you get 800 hours of work experience, which is usually paid as part of this program. And you can choose one of the eight streams that is at the bottom of the page. So depending on what engineering stream you're interested in, the most popular is mechanical, but we have a range, as you can see. Now, this is the Bachelor of Arts. So this is a 3-year degree, and this has a very wide range of different majors that you can choose. So you can see over 20 majors at the bottom of the page there. Now, this one has intakes in February and July, and again, it's a 3-year degree. And the tuition fees vary depending on the programme of study that you take, but are normally between maybe 17 and 23,000 US dollars or so per year. A number of these programmes do have opportunities for placements or internships. It really very much depends on the major that you choose. But if you do want a placement or an internship, we will do our best to place you within a community group or a business within Hamilton or Tauranga, depending on where you're studying. And then this is the Bachelor of Science. The Bachelor of Science has 12 majors, as you can see here. Again, it's a 3-year degree with intakes in February and July. You can see the cost about 20,000 US dollars there. And you would study, depending on your major, within the Faculty of Science and Engineering or Computing and Mathematical Science. And if you choose the Bachelor of Science in Technology, then that would include 10 weeks of paid work experience at the end of the second year. So certain majors would have that option. And most subjects also include laboratory work, field trips, and so on. And just one more interesting major that's slightly different to maybe the normal modes of study that international students choose. This is the Bachelor of Health, Sport, and Human Performance. And this is something that we specialize in at the University of Waikato. So it's a 3-year bachelor's degree. Again, it has intakes in February, March, and July time. The cost is about 15,000, or 16,000 maybe, US dollars. We have partnerships with sports bodies within New Zealand, national sports bodies and international sports bodies. And we have excellent facilities, both in Hamilton and Tauranga. So you can choose between community health, human performance science, and sports development and coaching. Now, if you don't meet our entry requirements for direct entry, then you can study at Waikato Pathways College, and that will give you a pathway into degree level study. And that can be either for foundation or for English language. So if you don't meet our academic entry requirements, you may start with a foundation degree. If you don't meet our English language requirements, then you may start with a short English language programme. So the Pathways College is on campus with small class sizes, individualized attention and specialized staff speaking different languages. It really is a very supportive place to start your studies. If you are looking to start with a foundation program, then the fact that it's on campus and that you have access to all of the facilities is very important. A lot of university foundation programs are not on their main campus. So do have a look at that if you're looking at a foundation program. Now, as I say, our English language requirements depend on the different programs that you might study. But for bachelor's degree, you would need IELTS of 6 with no less than 5.5 in all bands. So it would take 10 weeks for you to increase your IELTS by 0.5 of a band. So, for example, if you had IELTS of 5, you would study for 20 weeks at our Pathways College in order to improve your IELTS to 6 and then enter the first year of a bachelor's degree. If you're coming from the Indian school system, as I say, you can see our entry requirements in a second, but I believe 65% is what you would need from your English language studies. Now, the next slide I'd like to talk to you about is scholarships. And so you can see the 4 different scholarships that may be applicable to you here. Now, the most popular scholarship is the International Excellence Scholarship that we offer. and this is up to 10,000 New Zealand dollars. So if you achieve high grades in your current studies, we say normally B plus or higher, then you may be eligible for a scholarship of up to 10,000 New Zealand dollars to help you with your studies. This is applied to the first year of study only, and the higher grades you have, the bigger the scholarship that you'll receive. And then if you just look down to the International High Achievement Scholarship at the bottom of that table, if you then progress from the first year to the second year of your studies and you achieve B plus average in the first year, then you will be eligible for a further 5,000 New Zealand dollar scholarship towards your second year tuition fees. The two other scholarships we offer, I've mentioned the Tauranga Bursary, and that's for students studying at our Tauranga campus and can be up to 10,000 New Zealand dollars as a tuition fee reduction, and it's automatically applied to students who are enrolling at Tauranga. And then if you study on a foundation program or an international diploma, which is a kind of international first year, giving you direct entry to the second year of study, then we do again have scholarships of up to 10,000 New Zealand dollars available. And both of that scholarship and the International Excellence Scholarship are awarded through a competitive application process. Now, I've talked about our entry requirements already. Just talking about bachelor's degree study. So if you want to come and study with us and enter the first year of a bachelor's degree, and if you're studying through the Indian school system, then you would need 75% average from your studies. For English language here, actually, you can see it's 60%. I think this has just been reviewed and changed. So now you would need 60% in your studies from the Indian school system in English language in order to have your IELTS and English requirements waived and enter directly into the first year of study. And you can see that it varies by country. If you have a lower attainment than that, then you may go into a foundation program. So finally, just to give you an idea of our halls of residence, where you might live if you studied with us in New Zealand, we have catered and self-catered halls, both on campus. Catered halls include breakfast, lunch and dinner for all students in a canteen as part of the halls complex. And all students have a private bedroom, but most students will share a bathroom and share a small living area. Now, the catered halls are good for students who are moving away from home for the first time. And we do always recommend that students coming from high school should live in the catered halls, just because it's easier. You don't have to worry about cooking food and looking after all of those different aspects of life. If though you prefer self-catered halls, we have a number of self-catered halls on campus, and these include a kitchen where you cook your own food. Again, a private bedroom, normally a shared bathroom and a living area, and a kitchen, as I say. And you can see the costs down here. So the catered halls between 322 to 380 New Zealand dollars, and then the self-catered halls 200 to 265 New Zealand dollars per week. You may also consider a homestay if you're coming to New Zealand for the first time, and you can live with a host family in Hamilton. There's an English-speaking environment, obviously, close to the campus with a private bedroom, all meals provided, you can see the costs there, 266 New Zealand dollars per week with a $330 placement fee. And then maybe in your second year, you may have made friends in Hamilton or Tauranga, and you may want to consider moving into a shared house with friends. There are lots of housing options around both campuses. And the cost is around 200 to 250 New Zealand dollars per week, including bills. So that's the end of my presentation today. I don't know if anyone has any questions, but I'm more than happy to open up the floor to any questions you may have about the presentation, about living and studying in New Zealand. But I would just want to say thank you very much for listening to me today, and good luck with your studies, and I hope that you're able to come and study with us in New Zealand at some time in the near future. Thank you very much.
That was an impressive and informative presentation put forth by you, sir. Now let's move on to the queries from our audience.
So I think if anyone has any questions, they can type them into the chat function, and I'm happy to answer any questions that anyone has.
A gentle reminder to the audience present here to fill the feedback form. The link to the Google form has been posted in the chat room.
So at the moment, it doesn't seem like we have any questions. I think that, we do have a question, I take it back. So we have a question here asking whether engineering programs are available on the Tauranga campus. The answer is that yes, we do have engineering programs available. It's a bit of a complicated one. If you started your studies in engineering at Tauranga, you can actually study the first year there. And then in the second and third year, you would actually need to return to Hamilton and study the second and third year of the program in Hamilton. And then the final year, you can go back to Tauranga and complete the program there. So yes, it would be split between the Tauranga and the Hamilton campuses. And that's because there are very specific lab facilities that are needed for engineering. And our Hamilton campus has those facilities. So you would need to study part of your degree in Hamilton. Having said that, if you start your studies in Tauranga, then you would be eligible for the Tauranga bursary. So hopefully that will help you with your tuition fees. Okay, another question that's come up. Does the university offer nursing courses? Again, this is a little bit complicated. We do offer a nursing program. At the moment, it's only open to domestic students. So unfortunately, we don't offer nursing programs to international students currently. We are hoping to open that program up to international students in the near future. It depends on the placements that are available, because of course a very important part of a nursing degree is placement in a hospital or a care setting, and we only have a limited number of those placements, so at the moment there are only enough for domestic students. But please do stay in touch and keep looking at our website with for more information, and hopefully in the future we will be able to offer nursing programs. The next question we've got here, are there courses related to cybersecurity? The answer is yes. Now, for a bachelor's degree level, because cybersecurity is a very specific field, we don't offer a Bachelor of Cybersecurity. It's something that we offer at master's level. So you would study the Master of Cybersecurity. However, we do offer the Bachelor of Computer Science. And so aspects of the Bachelor of Computer Science would focus on cybersecurity. It's a very important field at the moment, and obviously something that is a real growth area when it comes to jobs. So yes, I mean, I would certainly suggest that you consider studying a Bachelor of Computing if you're interested in cybersecurity, and then specialize in cybersecurity at master's level. That's what a lot of students do. A Bachelor of Computing will allow you to gain a wide breadth of knowledge in many different areas of computing, and then, as I say, focus on cybersecurity, which is a very narrow field of computing at postgraduate level. The next question, are there any medical courses available to international students? We do offer something called the Bachelor of Health. That is more related to biomedical science and community health. So it's not a medical degree. There are only two universities that offer the Bachelor of Medicine, and they are the University of Auckland and the University of Otago. So if you are interested in studying medicine in New Zealand, then do consider contacting the University of Auckland or the University of Otago for more information. Okay, I'm happy to take any other questions if anyone has them.
Do you offer job visa to students after completion of courses in your country?
So I covered some of that in my presentation. So I talked about the 3-year post-study work visa. After completing a bachelor's degree, all students are eligible for a 3-year post-study work visa. So you can stay in New Zealand and you can work in any job for 3 years. The university itself has an international student services desk, and you can go to that department and you can ask them for assistance with visa applications. So when you get close to finishing your studies, if you want to stay in New Zealand and apply for the 3-year post-study work visa, then we can assist you in applying for that. The only reason you wouldn't be accepted is on medical or health reasons, or if you know, something had happened in your degree that the New Zealand government wasn't happy about, but generally we very rarely have problems with students applying for post-study work visas.
Thank you, sir. Does Waikato University offer any PhD programs?
Yes, we offer both master's and PhD programs. In New Zealand, PhD students actually pay domestic fees even if they are international students. It's a New Zealand government policy that we want to attract research interest and expertise into New Zealand. So yes, we offer a range of PhD programs, and the fees are a lot lower compared to the international fees that you would normally pay as an international student. But of course, then the application process is very competitive, and it means that you have to submit a very strong PhD application. And as I say, we offer a number of master's programs as well. So when students have completed their bachelor's degree, they're able then to progress onto a master's degree in a much more specialist field or area, which will allow them to hopefully get the job they want. I can see one more question that's just come up here. What are the sports played in the university? That's quite a good question, actually. So in New Zealand, the most popular sport is rugby. Now, rugby is not so popular in many parts of the world, but because New Zealand has a long tradition of rugby, and the All Blacks, if you've heard of the All Blacks, they are the New Zealand rugby team. They are the best rugby team in the world, and they have been for a long time. They didn't win the World Cup last time, unfortunately, but they are very strong. And it means that New Zealand rugby is played across New Zealand, so that's probably the most popular sport. Cricket is another very popular sport in New Zealand. Soccer, football as well. And then, of course, things like netball, basketball, all of those different sports. The university itself has something called UniRec, which is the sort of sports centre on campus. So you can join UniRec and you can join different sports teams and play sports alongside your studies. And then, of course, there are lots of different sports clubs that are run by the university, and lots of different sports clubs outside of the university as well. So if you have a particular sport that you're interested in pursuing or continuing to pursue, it's very likely that we'll have it and you'll be able to continue in that sport.
Thank you, sir. What, according to you, is the most attracting point in choosing Waikato University for higher studies?
This is a question I'm asked quite often, and it's a difficult question. I would turn that question on its head, and I would say that students should pick the university that's most suited to them. So something that appeals very much to one student about Waikato and New Zealand may not appeal at all to another student. As I've said, the lifestyle in New Zealand is more laid back and more relaxed than other countries. And I've said that New Zealand, if a student wants a really big city with crowds of people, 24-hour party lifestyle, lots and lots and lots of students and lots going on all the time, maybe New Zealand isn't so suitable for them. But if they want a more laid back, high quality environment where there are fewer international students, where everything is a bit quieter, but you have natural beauty all around, peace and quiet, really beautiful places to be based for your studies and visit, then New Zealand may well appeal to you. I think that our Triple Crown accredited management school is very appealing to international students because it means our management school is within the top 1% of management schools worldwide. So that's probably something that is most appealing if I was to answer that question. But as I say, I think students should choose the study destination that's right for them, the university that's right for them, and the programme of study that's right for them. And that doesn't always correspond to rankings because there are lots of different factors that you need to consider.
Thank you, sir. What are the bachelors of health, sport and performance?
So what is that that you want, you're asking about the Bachelor of Health, Sport and Human Performance?
Yes.
Yeah, and so that was one of the slides that I showed you a bit earlier, and I'll go back to that slide there. This programme is, as I say, it's a specialism of the university, and we have quite a lot of students studying in sport and health, human performance on this programme. So this is for students maybe who want to go into coaching, for example, sports coaching, or they want to go into sports development, or they want to go into jobs and careers where they're looking at athletes' performance and how to ensure that an athlete performs at the very top of their ability. So obviously that might relate to the diet that they're on, it may relate to the type of training they're doing, it may relate to their sleep patterns and so on and so on. So if a student was interested in pursuing a career maybe in one of those areas, this program would be very suitable for them. The university itself has excellent facilities. We have links, as I was saying, to international bodies and national bodies, which will give students access to a lot of information and knowledge that they're able to use in their future careers. You can see some of the facilities and the bodies on this this slide here. So the type of bodies and organisations we have links with. So it's quite a unique programme, quite a unique degree, and something that would suit a student who is interested in pursuing a career in sports development, coaching, performance, and that type of thing.
Thank you, sir. The final question, what kind of jobs will this particular course offer in New Zealand?
Yeah, so as I say, this programme here, it will offer students a job in an area either of sports development or coaching, human performance science. Community health is a bit more specialist. So I'll start with that one. That one maybe is working in the community, looking at different health issues. Secondly, human performance science, as I say, is looking at performance of athletes and how they can perform to the best of their abilities. So they may become a sports trainer or a sports an analyst, maybe related to that sort of performance side of sports. And then thirdly, they may become a coach. A sports coach working for a sports body or a club, working in their coaching staff.
Thank you, sir. As we come to the end of an enlightening session, I would like to express our gratitude to each and everyone behind the grand success of this session. First and foremost, I express our profound gratitude to His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq for his great vision, leadership and benevolence. May the Almighty bless His Majesty and this beautiful nation with peace and prosperity. On behalf of Indian School Muscat, the organizing team and the wonderful audience, I deem it my privilege to extend a very hearty vote of thanks to our speakers from the Waikato University, New Zealand. We sincerely appreciate the time and efforts you took to share with us the courses you offer. Wholeheartedly, I thank the chairman, Dr. Baby Sam Samuel, and members on the board of directors, Indian Schools in the Sultanate of Oman, Mr. Ajay Kumar J. Pillai, president, and members of Indian School Muscat Management Committee, our honorable principal, Dr. Rajiv Kumar Chauhan, presidents, and members of all Indian School Management Committees in the Sultanate of Oman, principals, vice principals, assistant vice principals, supervisors, coordinators, heads of departments, and teachers for their support and guidance for organizing such an event. Thank you all for supporting and encouraging all of us. I thank all the students and parents community for being with us today and for your active participation during the entire program. A big thank you to my Indian School Muscat team for making Avenue 2020 happen. Signing off is Palkin Jain of Class 11F, Indian School Muscat. Thank you once again. Wishing you all success in your future endeavors. Stay safe.